Ladies and gentlemen, I am Sid Alpha, and the game that is currently on a small section of your screen is Abrams Tank, a first-person shooter that is an extremely faithful rendition of an early 90s first-person shooter. So faithful, in fact, that the game overlooks a great deal of aspects that one would expect to find in a PC game. Now, there are two main reasons that I chose this particular game. The first is, I thought it would be a good opportunity to discuss the idea of retro within modern video games. And also, I do want to take a few moments to also inform you all of the exceptionally toxic and dishonest actions of the game's developer, Hard Disk Productions. But before we get into that, let's cover the idea of retro and what that entails, along with common mistakes that many developers make. You see, retro is a somewhat popular style within the video game industry. The idea of 8-bit graphics gives some gamers a sense of nostalgia, but for some elderly gamers, such as myself, we grew up during the time when those games were the industry standard, and we remember them well, and quite often, they're remembered through rose-colored glasses. Games from that time would be considered extremely lacking in nearly every area compared to today's current standards, and no, I'm not talking about just graphics alone. I've stated numerous times, and I feel very strongly, that great graphics do not a good game make. Far from it, I have found interesting and extremely fun indie games that were merely text-based or 8-bit graphics. Games like FTL would be a fantastic example of a great game well done that has very basic graphics, but games like those took the concept of old-style games with a nostalgic graphics and feel and mixed in some modern improvements. You see, nostalgia over video games more often than not will not translate to their options menus, controls, or overall screen resolution. In fact, it was their general lack of all of those that made them frustrating in the extreme in some cases. I recall when you had to configure COM ports and IRQ settings in the game's options menus just to get the sound to work properly. In some games, resolution changes and a host of other control changes were handled via configuration files that one had to edit, as those options weren't within the game's graphical interface. Compared to modern video games, they were a nightmare. And yet, they are considered nostalgic. And it is because of that nostalgia factor that so many independent developers attempt to touch on that particular chord within gamers. But in so many ways, they don't understand that in so closely replicating the games of the past, they're also replicating those parts of older games that people didn't like. The lack of key rebinding, lack of adjustable volume, lack of more robust control schemes, just a general lack. There were so many aspects of those games that were left wanting that it is actually a shame to see them in more modern titles. Games like Abrams Tank that makes all of those mistakes and more. The graphics we can work past, but there are so many things wrong with this game that I scarcely knew where to begin. But let's start with the game's resolution. First, there are of course no graphics settings and no way to enter into full screen within the game. This is a huge problem for gamers to be forced to deal with. If you put yourself into the shoes of the game developer, think about what your customer might want. Do you really think they'll thank you for forcing them to only make use of 1/6 of their monitors or less? No, more often than not, they won't. It causes frustration and makes someone not want to play your game, and they're far less likely to recommend it to others on top of it. Secondly, the lack of graphics and audio options within the game itself. Also, due to the overly simplistic controls and a lack of provided key map, I ended up mashing my keyboard just to find out where the button was to fire your cannon. It is not a good game by any means, but if this game were to take into consideration modern screen resolutions and other aspects of understanding the platform on which you're even selling the game, it could at least be passable for a $1 title. However, what we're left with here, due to the overly zealous dedication to the games of that time period and genre, we're left with a chore of a game with horrible sound effects that actually managed to give me a headache. I would recommend not supporting this game just on my impressions of the gameplay alone, but unfortunately for the community, the developers themselves have of course decided to take things to the next level. This particular developer has an apparent complete lack of ability to handle criticism. In order to find evidence of this, one need look no further than the game's description. At the bottom of the description, the developers had the following to say. Thanks for playing, and yes, don't listen to that dumbass driver shaft that posted that negative review. He's too much of a thick dum-dum to realize that the game's an exact replica of another older game. He doesn't really understand older games or games in general, he just collects trading cards, ignore the card whore's review. And Drivershaft, the user who posted the negative review that has the developer so bent out of shape, seemed like a fairly reasonable critique of the game and one well worth taking heed of. This person wasn't bashing the developer in any way and completely refrains from being antagonistic at all. All in all, it was a solid review, and given my own experience with the game, I feel his opinion has the game dead to rights. The developer accuses Driver Shaft as being a quote, card whore, even though nowhere in this person's review were trading cards even mentioned. Also, a conversation between the two were posted that shows the developer harassing and name-calling Driver Shaft over the fact that he got the game in a bundle, stating that it is a shitty consumer habit and refers to people who purchase their games through bundles as leeches. Throughout the entire conversation, the developer is deliberately antagonistic towards Driver Shaft, and his statements very much paint the picture of a person that thinks that any customer who doesn't pay full price for his game and doesn't leave a positive review then are absolute scum and are taking money out of his pocket. In an effort to continue harassment of Driver Shaft, the developer created a Steam account just to post his own review of the game in order to further attack him and his fair review of the game. Not only that, the developer has posted an additional review of their own game, which is a violation of Steam Terms of Service and is not only misrepresenting the game to potential customers, but is also duplicitous and utterly dishonest. The review in question is posted by Zombie3D, who does show as one of Abrams Tank's developers. And just for icing on the cake, the developer has decided to continue the harassment outside of Steam on Twitter, posting comments about a small YouTuber, Doom the Robot, a channel with less than 1,000 subscribers at the time of this recording. All of this is just more and more examples of this developer's toxic behavior and personality. I would recommend to everyone that you avoid this game at all costs. Please do not support a developer who would so willingly berate and harass their customers, post fake reviews, and behave in such a petty fashion that one would believe they went to the Digital Homicide School of Game Design. This game has too few redeemable qualities in my estimation. The developers have zero redeeming qualities, not to mention they've also violated Steam's rules and guidelines on more than one occasion. Developers harassing Steam users seems to be a growing issue on the Steam storefront, and I do sincerely hope that this is not the future of gaming on Steam. Regardless, I will be posting a review of this game on the Steam storefront, and I will be reporting the developer for posting fake reviews. I would also like to, of course, remind everyone to not directly attack the developer over these issues. Cool and calm heads resolve issues. Angry mobs cause them. I would like to take a moment to offer special thanks to Melo Online and Guardians of Greenlight for piecing together all of the visual evidence shown within this video. Their continued efforts to protect Steam users from developers like these are an inspiration. And as always, I would love to know what you all think about this game and this video down in the comments. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, I am Sid Alpha, and I'll see you next time.